Many changes occur when normal cells transform into cancer cells. Three of these changes allow cancer cells to make a unique and destructive environment, drastically different from normal cells. Number one, cancer cells excrete acid. Normal cells do not. Number two, cancer cells excrete enzymes. Normal cells do not. Number three, cancer cells form a protective coating against the acid and enzymes. Normal cells do not. The cloud of acid and enzymes excreted by cancer cells dissolves and kills nearby normal cells. Cancer cells produce a unique and destructive environment with the acid, the enzymes, and the protective coating. This environment would make a fantastic target since only cancer cells make it and normal cells do not. 14 years ago, a researcher named Dr. Key noted that lysosomes, a component found in cells, also creates a unique and destructive environment. Lysosomes and cancer cells make the exact same environment. Both have acid, both have enzymes, both have protective coating against the acid and enzymes. Cancer cells use this environment to kill nearby normal cells. Lysosomes use this environment to break down and recycle parts for the cell to reuse. Dr. Key hypothesized that since the environment of lysosomes is the same as cancer cells, there might be an item inside lysosomes that could be used against cancer cells. If that item can coexist and operate with the acid, the enzyme, and the protective coating in lysosomes, then it is possible that the item could target and operate using cancer cells' acids, enzymes, and protective coating as well. In fact, there is an item that does that. It is a protein called saposin C. It's worth knowing how saposin C works in the environment of lysosomes. Then it will be easier to understand how saposin C works in the environment of cancer cells. In lysosomes, saposin C operates in three sequential steps. First, in an acid environment, saposin C turns on. Second, once saposin C is turned on, it can attach to the protective coating inside a lysosome. This protective coating consists of a lipid called phosphatidylserine. Third, after saposin C attaches to the protective coating, it can attach and activate many different kinds of enzymes. With cancer cells' environment, saposin C uses the same three steps. First, saposin C is turned on by cancer's acid environment. Saposin C stays off with normal cells. Second, once turned on, saposin C attaches to the protective coating. It cannot attach to normal cells since they do not have the protective coating. Third, after saposin C attaches to the protective coating, it activates a specific enzyme called acid sphingomyelinase, which is normally found within the cell wall. When this enzyme is activated, a lipid called ceramide is produced. When high amounts of ceramide are produced, the suicide signal is turned on and the cell will die. Dr. Key created the drug by combining saposin C with a lipid. With this combination, a miniaturized cell, a kind of nanocell, is formed. In this form, the drug can travel throughout the body, including the brain. This is what the drug looks like in action. The drug can circulate throughout the body. It passes over normal cells. The drug will attach to cancer cells and then increases the ceramide to the point where cancer cells will die.